Yo, what is up guys? My name is The Legend. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to my video. Thank you for clicking on it. Today, I want to talk to you guys about how to win more gunfights in Black Ops 3. Every year, this is something that everybody wants to know with every new installment of Call of Duty or any FPS game, really. Really, it's any FPS game, but I'm going to show you guys how to do that. Some tips and tricks, something for you guys to follow. And if you guys enjoy that, if you guys like, that would be great. I hope you guys are willing to do that. Now, if that interests you, then don't go anywhere because we're just getting started. Alrighty, so no dilly-dally, let's get right into it. First and foremost, number one, you're gonna wanna know where your enemies are. Now, that's not just the UAV. You use the UAV, but you have to know what the hell you're doing. So, if you guys are interested in knowing more about that, I'm not gonna go over it in this video because it's a whole lot of things that you have to talk about. It's a whole video on its own. Click on the video that's on your screen right now. It'll open up in a different tab, so don't even worry about that. And click it because that is going to show you guys how to have shooter awareness. That's what I like to call it, shooter awareness. And just knowing where people are pre-shooting, it's going to help you guys a lot. Don't just skip it because it's important, guys. You do need to know how to do this. Very important. Do not just blow it up. I hope you guys click on that. Now, next, we're going to want to learn how to stick to the edge of the map. You got to stick to the edge of the map. It's very important, guys. You have to stick to the edge of the map. Because, see, people will not be able to get you from the back, and they won't really be able to get you from the flank. Instead, you'll be flanking enemies because a lot of them like to be in the middle of the map. That's why the middle of the map is usually the most dangerous, the part of the map that's going to get you killed the most. You want to stay away from that, and you want to stay at the flank, which is the edge of the map. Rush the edge of the map. Number three, I want you guys to remember to aim around corners. Don't just rush through them, okay? Do not run over corners. I think that's called hugging corners or something like that. Do not do that, please. Do not do that because that is going to shoot you, and that is going to make you die. Okay, do not do that. You want to make sure that you're aiming when you come across a corner, or at least walk, but please don't sprint. Please don't sprint because you're going to die. And that's not what I want, okay? I want you guys to be good at FPS games. That's what my whole channel is about. It's about helping you guys become better players at FPS games. I don't want you guys to die. Please do not rush around corners. Remember to always aim down sights when you're around corners. Now, for the next little tip here, claw your controller. That is just when you're using your index finger to press the face buttons and your middle finger to use the R1 and the L1, or the RB and the LRT? I don't even know. I don't play Xbox, but yeah, you guys get the idea. Claw your controller. Learn to do that. It sucks at the beginning because you're gonna die a lot, but get used to it. Maybe in custom games, get used to it. Like, now I've done it so long that doing it how everybody else does it with their thumbs, you know, handling the face buttons, and their index fingers handling R1 and L1, I actually do not feel comfortable doing it that way because I'm so used to clawing my controller. I recommend you guys just do it. It's going to help you in the long run. Learn to do it. Just learn. Just give it a try. Alrighty, so let's get into some attachments here that I recommend. I recommend you guys use high caliber, definitely high caliber, and quick draw. Oh, quick draw is a big one. I definitely recommend quick draw. You guys really want to run this one because it's going to help you put your gun up in the air faster, going to aim down sights faster, and that is going to give you a split second extra, and that split second could mean everything, guys. It can mean the whole gunfight. Definitely run quick draw. And then I want you guys to run the foregrip because the foregrip is gonna help you keep your bullets on target and just hit those bullets on the enemy. It's gonna help you out. Definitely want to run that. And for your perks, I want you guys to run fast hands. It's a big one. That one's gonna help you help the quick draw. It works hand in hand. And then sixth sense, because you'll know where everybody is without actually needing to see them. You'll know where because of your radar. And then the ghost, so that people cannot see you on their radar. So I want you guys to run those perks. Maybe you guys know any better ones that you guys like more, but I do recommend those ones. And the last little tip that I have for you guys here today, I want you guys to use the head glitches. The head glitches are everywhere in Treyarch maps. They're everywhere. Everybody's going to use them. So if you don't like to use them, you're really at a big disadvantage. But honestly, I don't know anybody who doesn't like to use them. No, I don't think anybody doesn't like to use them, but there are some people that do stick to just trying to, for the most part, just, you know, trying to do it a little bit fairer, I guess, which honestly, I still think it's fair to use head glitches. I don't think that's cheating. I mean, it's there, but some people do. I don't know, who freaking knows, right? Anyway, I think it's about time to wrap it up. That's almost a 5-minute video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you learned something. Check out my channel. FPS is everything on my channel. Gonna teach you guys to become better players. And if you guys like the video, then I'll see you guys back here again someday. And if I do, then I'll catch you in the next one.